Whoa, look at that.
Are negative ion products good for you? Or are they dangerous? This necklace from Amazon says that it will improve your body's circulation, recharge your body's energy field, and enhance your immune and endocrine system. The instructions for this negative ion wand say to use it in your food and your drinks to neutralize harmful elements and increase the absorption of nutrients to support healing and strengthen immunity. And you can get what looks like the exact same item on AliExpress, which as well as that function says to use it on your skin to prevent aging. And there's this terahertz card designed for children that says it produces negative ions. You're supposed to wear it during the day and sleep with it under your pillow at night. It says it will destroy bacteria and viruses in the body, boost their immune system, and improve their sleep quality. And as crazy and unbelievable as all of those health claims sound, there have actually been hundreds and hundreds of scientific studies into the effects of negative ions on humans, bacteria, and plant growth. And there are so many studies. And I feel like when there's that many, if you're trying to sell something, you can always find one that says what you want it to say. But if you're not interested in sales and you are interested in your health, when there's that many studies, what you need to do is get a group of scientists who have expertise in that area to read all the studies and then give you an overall picture of what is going on. A group of scientists in Singapore have done just that, and we'll get to those results later. But first, what even is a negative ion? A negative ion is just an atom or a molecule that has gained an extra electron, so it has a negative charge. And typically, studies that are looking at the possible health benefits of negative ions are talking about negative ions in the air around you. And negative ions in the air are typically not very stable. They'll usually only last for a few seconds through to a minute and a half at the most. Now, how many negative ions are around you that you're breathing in at this very moment depends on where you live. There are natural things that cause there to be negative ions in the air. One of those is cosmic rays. This is radiation that you can't see, and it accounts for about 20% of the negative ions in the air. Another source is radioactive elements. In the Earth, naturally, there's things like uranium and thorium, and as they decay, their radiation produces negative ions in the air, but obviously you don't want to be close to a radioactive source. The other thing that's interesting is right after a storm that's had thunder and lightning, there are more negative ions in the air immediately after that lightning. UV sunlight can also ionize the air, but that typically only happens in the upper levels of our atmosphere, and because they're not stable, by the time that air reaches down where we're going to breathe it in, they're no longer ionized. The other source that is at our level is waves and waterfalls. The shearing force of the water going over itself creates negative ions. So if you're standing very close to either of those, you'll be breathing them in. So as you can see, all of those sources require a considerable amount of energy or force to create negative ions. So how could any of these products possibly be producing negative ions? Well, the truth is, most of them don't produce any negative ions. They're just straight up lying to you. But some of them do, but not in a good way. If you think back to that list of natural sources, the only one that is going to fit into these products is radioactive elements. Now, if you're thinking, I thought radiation was bad for you, then you'd be right. The amount obviously makes a big difference. A large dose all at once is going to be deadly, but small doses over time are still not good for you and can damage your DNA and lead to cancer. So for that reason, the International Commission on Radiological Protection says that excluding background radiation that you can't do anything about, members of the general public should not be exposed to more than 1 millisievert of ionizing radiation per year. Obviously, the less you're exposed to, the better, so you're trying to avoid it. Sometimes, though, you might need something like an X-ray, which will expose you to ionizing radiation, and so they try and only do them if they're medically necessary, and therefore the benefit would outweigh the cost in that situation. as far as selling products that have radioactive substances in them, there is limits for that too. The International Atomic Energy Agency has a safety standard that says any one source is only exempt from regulation if the effective dose incurred to any person is less than 0.01 millisieverts per year. So how do we know if these products are emitting ionizing radiation or not? We can't see ionizing radiation, obviously, but we can see the effects of it if we build a cloud chamber. To do that, we just need some dry ice in a box or a container, and then a sheet of thick aluminium, and I've painted one side of this black so that we can see better. And then we just need some felt in a clear container that we're going to soak that felt with isopropyl alcohol, which is at least 95%. And then we quickly flip that upside down and put it on top of our cold sheet. And then we just need to turn the lights off and wait about 10 minutes. Now what's going to happen is the isopropyl alcohol around the top is going to be warm and it's going to evaporate. And then as it heads down towards the very cold plate at the bottom, it's going to want to form back into a liquid. And you might be able to see the little misty drops as they're going down. Now, any radiation that is shot off from the products that we have will be able to be seen as a trail in that mist. It'll create like a little cloud behind it, a bit like the contrail you see behind an aeroplane when it's in the sky, except in this case, the particles are going much faster than an aeroplane and they're so tiny that we can't see the particle, just the trail behind it. Now, in Australia, we have very low levels of background radiation, so that's actually really useful for doing this experiment when we want to see what's coming from a source. Now, before we test the products, I really want to test this uranium glass that I have. This glass was made with uranium in it, and most of these pieces emit little or no radiation at all, which is great, and that's because the amount of uranium in them is so minimal. But some of them are actually quite hot. They have quite a lot of uranium in them. I've never tested this one before, so let's have a look. There's a little bit coming off this one chipped corner. Can you see those tiny wisps? Let me show you from above. The static white is just the light reflecting off the glass, but the movement you see is the trails caused by radiation, and that's what we're looking for. So there's only a little bit coming from this one, but let's take a look at the ionizing wand. Wow, there is a lot more going on now, and it's shooting all over the place. It's actually quite hard to film because of the low light. The camera is only focusing on a small cross section of it, so I can see it everywhere, but you can only see the bit that's in focus. Now, the shape of the trail that's left depends on if it is an alpha, beta, or gamma ray. Alpha leaves thicker, straighter, more obvious trails, but they're not as dangerous because they can't penetrate very far into your skin. You still don't want them, but they're not as bad. Beta rays can go through your skin and into your tissues, and gamma rays, they can go straight through you, leaving a trail of damage along the way. You'd need a thick layer of lead to stop those. Cloud chambers are great for visualizing radiation, but they don't actually tell us the quantity that's coming from it. I mean, obviously we can tell there's a lot more coming from the wand than there was from the bowl, but we don't know how much. For that, we're going to need a Geiger counter. Now, these can range in price all the way up to many thousands of dollars. This is one of the cheaper models, and because of that, it doesn't measure any alpha radiation at all. It only measures the beta and the gamma. So it's not going to give us the full reading, but it will give us a bit of an idea. So let's start with the bowl and see what it picks up for that. This is measuring in microsieverts, not millisieverts, and 0.07 microsieverts is the background radiation level here. Now it's saying that once we put it over the bowl, it's going up to 0.08, so a tiny, tiny amount. Now let's test the pen. That's going up, still going up. Let's set off the alarm. 1.26 microsieverts per hour. So if you stuck this pen in your pocket and took it to work with you for say 8 hours a day so that you can stir your food that you have and your drinks that you have during the day with it, that would be the same as having two dental x-rays every day. And if you did that all year, you'd be exposing yourself to 3.5 millisieverts of radiation, which is above the 1 millisievert limit, and obviously far above the 0.01 millisievert limit for products, which means this product requires regulation and should not be being sold to the public. On top of that risk, if you use it how they told you to and put it into the water, there is also the risk that some of that powder could leak out of the seal because it's just pushed in the top there, and you could end up consuming the radioactive material, which would be even more dangerous, obviously. Or in the case of this one, it might just come out of the hole in the end. One of them doesn't have a hole and one of them does, so it's obviously a manufacturing defect, but a dangerous defect at that one. Let's take a look at the card that was designed for children to wear. That one thankfully is reading much lower at 0.17 microsieverts per hour. But the use case for this is they tell you to get your child to wear it all day and have it under their pillow at night. So that's 24 hours a day that they're going to be exposed to this, and that adds up pretty quickly. By the end of a year, they would have been exposed to 1.5 millisieverts of radiation, or the equivalent of having a dental x-ray nearly every day of the year, and well above the 1 millisievert limit. Keep in mind as well, children and babies are more sensitive to the effects of radiation, so this product should, again, not be available. It should be regulated, and nobody should be putting it anywhere near their children. There have been lots of studies done on these sort of products that say that they produce negative ions. This one done in Malaysia tested all these different products and found they contained uranium or thorium or a mixture of both as the radioactive elements that were in them. Now, if you wore them as it's said to wear them, you would definitely be exposed to more than 1 millisievert of radiation per year. So they recommended that these products should be banned. Now, the Thought Emporium did a video on some of these topics more than 4 years ago and got some of the sellers shut down, but it appears like they're back. So I'm making this video to make you aware not to buy anything that promises health benefits through negative ions. Which brings us back to the initial question. Are negative ions even good for you if you can get them from a source that's not ionizing radiation? Because in that case, it's definitely going to be bad for you. The study that the scientists did, looking at all the research so far, concluded that there is no conclusive evidence of benefit, which what that means is some studies that have been done show that yes, this is going to be good for mood, or it's going to be good for this. And then when they try and repeat that study on another group of people, no benefit is found. There's no harm being found. So if you want to go stand near waterfalls or walk near the waves on the beach, it's not going to do you any harm. It may even make you feel good just because you're outside. But if you just want to try negative ions and you're nowhere near a waterfall or a beach, the good news is you can just go and have a long shower. The shearing force of the water coming through the shower head actually produces negative ions. You don't have to buy any of these products. You don't have to put your health at risk. You can just have a long shower. With thanks to my patrons for your support of this channel and allowing me to buy things like Geiger counters and make cloud chambers for you. If you're looking for a last minute Christmas gift, don't forget you can buy Dave's books or my cookbook. They would make a great gift. Make it a great week by being kind to others, and I'll see you on Friday.